near the end of October. Business was better. The war scare was over. More men were back at work. Sales were picking up. On this particular evening, October 30th, the Crosley Service estimated that 32 million people were listening in on radios.
Ladies and gentlemen, we interrupt our program of dance music to bring you a special bulletin from the Intercontinental Radio News. At 20 minutes before 8 Central Time, Professor Farrell of the Mount Jennings Observatory, Chicago, Illinois, reports observing several explosions of incandescent gas occurring at regular intervals on the planet Mars.
Someone's calling someone or something. I can see turning out of that black hole through luminous discs. The eyes, it might be a face, might be almost
Good
heavens, something wriggling out of the shadow like a gray snake. Now it's another one and another one and another one. They look like tentacles to me. Oh, yeah, I can see the thing's body. Now it's large, and large as a bear.
Good year, boys. Let's head home for the night.
I'll give you every detail as long as I can talk and as long as I can see. More state police have arrived. They're drawing up a cordon in front of the pit. About 30 of them. No need to push the crowd back now. They're willing to keep their distance.
Dale, you startled me. You're hearing this?
Someone. Can't quite see who.
Hearing what?
I believe it's Professor Pearson.
This?
Yes, it is. Now they've parted, and the professor moves around one side, studying the object while the captain and two policemen advance with something in their hands. I can see it now. It's a white handkerchief tied to a pole. Flag of truce. Those creatures know what that means, what anything means. Wait a minute, something's happening. Humped shape is rising out of the pit. I can make out a small beam of light against a mirror. What's that? There's a jet of flame springing from the mirror and it leaps right at the advancing men. It strikes them head on. Lord, they're turning into flames. The whole field's caught up by the woods of the fires. The gas tanks for the automobiles.
Where's Gene?
Coming this way now, about 20 yards.
Gene, come home now!
Requested by the governor of New Jersey to place the counties of Mercer and Middlesex as far west as Princeton and east to Jamesburg under martial law. No one will be permitted to enter this area except by special pass issued by state or military authorities. Four companies of state militia are proceeding from Trenton to Grover's Mill and will aid in the evacuation of homes within the range of military operations. Thank you.
Yeah, Gene?
Do you ever think about the stars?
What's there to think about? You come out when it's time to sleep, Gene. I guess no one's ever asked me that question before. Or one like it.
How come?
Only thing ever on your granddaddy's mind was how to keep the farm going. Now I worry about that. And if someone's gonna come and take it from us. What about you? You ever think of the stars?
Yes, sir, I do. I imagine.
Imagine?
Yeah, like Miss Leslie teaches us to do at school.
Okay.
I imagine other places up there, like here. But the things that live up there shine like the stars. And they're bigger than us, but friendlier than us, too. Guess it's all silly stuff, though. I'll have to work on the farm one day, too. Right, Dad?
You go ahead and think of the stars, son.
Citizens of the nation, I shall not try to conceal the gravity of the situation that confronts the country, nor the concern of your government in protecting the lives and property of its people. However, I wish to impress upon you, private citizens and public officials, all of you, the urgent need of calm and resourceful action.
This is Orson Welles, ladies and gentlemen. Out of character, to assure you that the War of the Worlds has no further significance than as the holiday offering it was intended to be. We annihilated the world before your very ears and utterly destroyed the CBS. You will be relieved, I hope, to learn that we didn't mean it and that both institutions are still open for business. So goodbye, everybody, and remember, please, for the next day or so, the terrible lesson you learned tonight. That grinning, glowing, globular invader of your living room is an inhabitant of the pumpkin patch, and if your doorbell rings and nobody's there, that was no Martian, it's Halloween.
Subscribe to Dust for new sci-fi every week.